Hey guys, what's going on? This is Larknok1/AKWAddict, and today I'm going to bring you guys a let's play of Sid Meier's Civilization Beyond Earth. So, I'm pretty active in the Beyond Earth subreddit, and I'm a decent player at this game. I'm not at the level at which I can just beat Apollo every time I play, but I'm comfortable at the point where I can pretty much beat Soyuz without much of a challenge. So today we're gonna be playing a mod called the Apollo Difficulty Legacy mod, and this is gonna create a difficulty setting that's between Soyuz and Apollo. It basically loads the old settings for Apollo pre-patch, which are a little easier than post-patch, but with the whole patch and the nerfs to internal trade routes and a bunch of other cheap techniques that we could use to win, Apollo is certainly a lot harder than it used to be. Even Legacy. So, what am I doing loading? We need to be setting up a game. Alright, so today, I'm thinking about what I tend to play with is Franco-Iberia here. I really, really love the free virtues. But I can tend to play with all of these. I prefer either the PAC, Franco-Iberia, or the Cavithan Protectorate and the African Union. The thing is about the African Union is they tend to be one of the far more powerful of the sponsors in this game. I only reserve them for when I play Apollo games, really, because of how good they are. So today I don't really want to showcase the best of the best, so... Although I totally am going to do that for the rest of these options down here. So I'm going to go with the PAC today. I really, really love how just efficient their workers are, and I love their the production bonus isn't bad either, honestly. Especially helps you build the gates at the end of the game. So I'm going to go with Artists here. As it stands, Artists is definitely better than the rest of these options. If Artists was slightly nerfed down to 2 culture in every city, honestly, it would be a very, very viable strategy. The moment, I'm just going to go with Artists. Tectonic Scanners is fantastic. I love when I can get Titanium in early cities, and I just really love Tectonic Scanner. I could go Retrograde Thrusters, but it's just not totally my strategy. And the rest of these options aren't too good. Connell Surveyor can be very good on Atlantean maps, but that's about it. So let's head into our last choice here. And this is pretty one-sided. Machinery. The Free Worker is better than a Soldier, it's better than a Clinic. I've seen some strategies that work with Laboratory or the Lab. They give the free Pioneering and not a free Lab, as you probably think. But, you know, Machinery, Worker, or the PAC, it all goes together, it all adds up. So, let's go into the advanced setup now and make sure that everything is outfitted properly. So we're playing on Apollo Legacy difficulty. We're going to be playing on a Protean map today. I really like how all of the AI and you are like forced together, condensed into one small area. We're going to go with standard map size for the most players without going into massive. And we're going to go with a random map terrain because I love all of the terrains in this game and I'm looking forward to seeing a random one. So other than that, we're going to be playing with contact disabled because I tend to think it's really cheap. It allows players to gimp victories a lot earlier than they should be able to. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Down here, quick combat. I'm actually going to turn this off so we have normal combat animations because they're very amusing to watch, and I know that. Quick movement, however, I have to keep on because it hurts me inside to see units like slowly walk, especially when you're commanding large armies. So we're going to keep that enabled. And this seems good, so without further ado, let us begin a game. While some looked to the stars and saw gods, I saw possibilities. Possibilities for a future that has finally come. We've explored the unknown sky, and I will colonize the alien shore. I will lead my people to great success as the Pan-Asian Cooperative discovers its new role in the universe. Thuggin. Daoming Soshua, I'm probably pronouncing that horribly wrong, is a complete badass. More power to her. Okay, what terrain are we gonna get? We got desert! Yes! One of my favorites. Alright, so looking at this start, we got Phyraxit down here. This is in Tundra. Tundra starts not the best. We are in a river, but this is mostly plains, and then tundra up just above us. Get tundra above us and tundra below us. So I think we're either very far south or very far north. Yeah, it's ice down there, so it looks like we're very far south. This is not too good. But good news is we do have fruit. So these on rivers. So these are going to be 3 food tiles, I think. Maybe 4 food. Can't tell. This is not horribly bad. Thing is, we do have 2 canyons here and 2 mountains and canyons here. So it is closing us off from quite a bit. I think I'm going to spawn... do I spawn over closer to this side? Or do I spawn over closer to this side? If I go over here, I'm kind of going into the unknown. I'm accessing tundra earlier than I have to. And yeah, if I go over here, I get access to the chitin on the river. It's a lot safer. I don't actually like this option because it brings me closer to the hills over here. So we're going to go here. We're going to land here. All right, so we do have petroleum in the first city. So this is good. We would not have had this had we not landed over here. But maybe if we landed over there, there'd be something cool too. It's always hard to tell. All right, so let us get moving. All right, so we have Phyraxite up here and Phyraxite down here. So it actually looks like we might be playing a Supremacy game, which is fantastic because I love playing Supremacy. All right, so our worker here, we're going to get to work. It's a good thing that we have Pan-Asian workers because cutting down these forests is going to be a total pain. Because of that, I might pick up a worker as my second build, but right now we're going to go with the safe build, older Threlics. They're fantastic. Alright, so as far as tech go, I have a very clear-cut early tech path. It goes with ecology, chemistry, and then pioneering. Ecology is really useful for the vivarium. I like to get my cities exploding as fast as I can. Chemistry here, we have the recycler, which is +2 production, and it quests for another +10% on workers. It also gives +1 food, but I really do prefer the workers. And the lab up here, which is one of the cheapest, best science buildings in the game. Right after that, we got pioneering, which is going to be my third tech. Again, trade depots are fantastic. They give another production. You can start trading with stations. If stations get extra production or give production, this is one of the best ways to gear up your capital to be able to start building a lot of colonists. And colonists are the future. So that's the plan. Let's start with ecology and see where that brings us. All right. Do I start trying to cut this down, or do I go over here for the safe? I think the safe is the best. Okay. Wow. We got a solar collector very, very early. That's very good. And we also have a crashed satellite here. So that's very good. Part of my culture strategy relies on getting expeditions. That said, I need to get to the second cultural tenet, or virtue, before I finish this. So we'll see how long this takes with this guy, and see whether or not we want to stay here, or we want to keep moving and doing a little bit of exploring. I'm not going to launch my solar collector yet. I want to wait for us to get to, like, 3 or 4 citizens, so the energy really starts pouring in, because you only have 60 turns of it up in the air. Okay. These wolf beetles are not... Ooh, that's scary. So that's 8 Xenomass. Unfortunately, it's in a very inaccessible position. And it is in snow. So that's no yield. And it looks like here the expedition is actually 4 turns. So I'm not going to pick that up now. Because I'm not going to be able to have field research by that time. So I go with a strategy in Virtues called 5K4M. And that basically builds a very strong culture backbone here, with the first trying to get this first synergy, and also picking up cohesive values. And what that's going to do is enable me to go to a lot of virtues in this game, and hopefully I'll be able to get down to adaptive sciences as soon as I can. This is going to help considerably with teching, getting better units, just basically advancing through the game, fast to the end. So that's going to be the strategy today. I'm not going to pick up that guy quite yet. And let's see where this takes us. Right. So we are in plains, so that's going to be troublesome. The good news is that we do have 2 fruits, and those are going to help us stay a bit afloat on food. And I think there's something that increases the food yield of plantations. Just don't remember where. I'm looking for that, because if we could find that, that'd be... Alright, photosystems. When we do eventually pick up photosystems, it'll help our capital out a bit. That's like very far away. Not quite 387 turns, but a distance. Alright, our first AI has landed. Who's it gonna be? Franco-Iberia.
Venez, mettez-vous à l'aise. Franco-Iberia vous accueille chaleureusement.
Hello. I love AI in this game. Alright, so let's just go about doing a little exploratoring. Some gold over there. Oh boy. Oh boy, it looks like Reggie to me. That's Reggie. There are two neighbors I hate in this game. It's Reggie, and then there's the ARC. Either will declare war on you just because they can. So this terrain is looking very cool. It's highly mountainous on that end, and there's a lot of tundra over here. So what this is telling me is that really to grow, we might need to go pick up the bio-well a bit early. Unless we end up going purity, which it doesn't look like we're doing. It looks like we're doing a supremacy build. The bio-well will help us get food to these cities, and we won't even have to cut down the forest where we see it, which is nice. We did get our first virtue here, and we're going to pick up foresight as part of the 5k4m. This is a very good virtue, not so good early game, but what I really want to get to is field research. This is going to be giving us a lot of science, it's going to be getting us to ecology faster, and yeah, so we do pick up the next virtue in 6 turns. And I believe this is actually a 4-turn expedition, so knowing that, that's 1 turn, 2 turns, 3, yep, I'm just actually going to go for it now. My second construction will be another explorer, so I'm not too concerned about not seeing the rest of the map yet. What I want to do is I want to get to ecology as fast as I can, especially because these food conditions are absolutely horrible. Oh boy. This is actually troublesome because it's in miasma, and it's right next door to a nest, so they might feel actually threatened. I hope not, but... Well, they're occupying the tile right now. Let me just sit by for a moment. I have not yet attacked the aliens. I have not given them an incentive to really attack me. So hopefully they don't be too aggressive. Let's get another explorer out. Alright, so now I can head into the swarm. That's 2 drones, though. That's very bad looking. I'm gonna do it anyways, because, screw the rules, huh? Well, you saved admirably. You served admirably. That's what I get. Look at that beautiful rookie mistake I just made. It's good stuff. Okay, next turn. The conditions are not the best. The only upside of an explorer dying, I suppose, is that you get your energy per turn a little earlier. The downside is that I don't get that crash satellite.
The African people greet you.
How you doing, Samatar? I like Samatar. He's a nice guy. The only thing is he can tend to be a runaway AI, meaning he can just take up a lot of land, grow very fast. It's because the AI tends to be very healthy, and Samatar Bare's ability lets him grow faster when he's healthy. Alright, so we want to pick up field research, even though we lost our ability to really do what I wanted to do with that. Oh well. And we are playing Supremacy, I think it looks like. So let's go with Domesticate Wildlife here. Alright, the Alien Preserve, sweet. Sometimes it can be the Xeno Nursery, and that's annoying. Alright, you've discovered Far Base 1. Far Base 1 provides 2 energy and 2 science to any city. Alright, Far Base 1, ooh, Fort Barca. Where's Fort Barca? Oh, it's still way out there. Alright, we're not going to be able to trade with anything that far, quite that far. We're getting another explorer up next turn. And with that, we can actually begin to see the landscape.
How may the corporation serve you?
Yielding landed. Alright, hopefully not close. Way out there. All right. Sweet. So we got Fielding and Reggie a good distance away from us. That is good. That leaves probably Polystralia to land near us. Has Kavitha touched down? I don't think Kavitha's touched down. She's one of the more passive players as well. All right, so we did get our our explorer. So now let's get to work on another worker because of how many forests this terrain has. I need to really make use of these river tiles sooner rather than later, honestly. So let's get our explorer out looking for usable land. Floatstone out there. Alright, let's see how our units are. Alright, they're spread decently. I suppose we could launch the solar collector now. We could wait until 4. Let me wait until 4. So we hit 4 citizens. Okay, here we are. More Phyraxite for our supremacy build. Not looking too shabby. This is a very bad city, though. Let's see how much I can make out of it. Alright, we got some 50 energy. Oh wow, that's a bunch of floatstone. It's looking like a purity player might land up there somewhere. Cut the forest for Tiangong. It's going to help us get that worker out a little bit quicker. One turn away. And I think that's going to give us gifts from home. Right? Nope, we need... Yeah, one more for gifts from home. So that's going to give us a considerable amount of science. We'll probably have ecology next turn. Alright, I'm just trying to gun it to cohesive values, which is really going to be critical, because 10% of what you get isn't too much, but a decrease of 10% on the cost is considerable. That's consistently a few turns cut off of that you have to spend. So let's get to work trying to get some farms down, huh? Alright.
When Coyote there we go. Learned he was the only one of his kind on the new planet, his howl echoed through the rifts and off the distant hills.
Alright, so we got ecology. So that's going to be very good. And we got 15 culture out of that. So it looks like there's probably another nest up there somewhere. So I want to pull this way. Titanium is very good. We're going to bring our explorer down this way. And we did just finish our worker. So let's get to work on building a vivarium. Because this city needs food desperately. Alright, so like I said, we're going to go chemistry now. This is going to give us access to the recycler and the lab, which are both very good. I'm also a big fan of petroleum. Petroleum is a great resource, especially when you've gotten the right techs for it and done the right things. It can be even better once you pick up the virtue in... Where is it? In Might. It gives +1 production from strategic resources and +1 energy. And petroleum is a strategic resource, so it really just helps buff it out. Let's just get a better vision on these hills. Even more Phyraxite. Yeah, we are definitely going Supremacy, and I love playing Supremacy. It's absolutely so much fun to manage their units. More petroleum. I like it. I'm looking for some food, though, and I'm just seeing a bunch of desert. So, vivariums abound, I suppose. Tiangong has grown to 4.
Come, Miss Ahmad.
Hello there, Hutsama.
The Commonwealth welcomes you.
Where did you land, sir? Way up there. Have all the AI landed? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. No, it seems like there's another 2 AI that need to drop. Alright, we got science there? Yes. And, oh yes, even more Phyraxite. A lot of floatstone, though. It looks like we could choose to go Purity if we wanted, but we did already choose a quest that forces us between Harmony and Supremacy if we want to play optimally. And I'm all about that life. So, let us now launch the Solar Collector. Let's just check where the units are. Two out here, over here. I suppose that's because we're still working on these tiles. Let's launch this guy, though. I'm thinking right here is a safe spot, especially because we want to improve these two tiles soon. And that'll bring us up to 11 energy per turn. Hopefully, then, we'll be able to buy a few colonists before We're too stressed out. Tiangong's not the best city I've ever seen, but it'll do. Let's open fire on these guys. Missiles against indigenous species. That just does not sound like a fair fight. Sounds like a great spot over here for a city. It's a little far. We want to build that way. I really want to see what's over here. I hope it's a lot of Phyraxite. Alright, I'm going to get over here. And I'm going to build a generator. That looks like a good spot for a generator. One of my favorite spots in the game for generators are Plains River. That's just a great spot for a generator. Because you get one food, one production, three energy. It's just a good mix. I like it. Even more petroleum. Looks like we're going to have a little petroleum empire on our hands. All right, we got another resource pot out here. Some fruit. And we'll pick up cohesive values now. So, currently this is 56 culture for this virtue. And when we pick up cohesive values here, the next one will be 75. But it would be a little bit more than that, I suppose. Let's pick up the generator now, or we could go farm. I'm gonna go with a generator. Actually, no. We could go generators here, and they'll be affected by the solar collector a little better than that. So let's go with farms. A little bit safer earlier. I like to get to 4 food sources before I really start building production sources and energy sources. So let's do that. Next turn. Let's pick up the solar collector. Resource pod. Even more energy. Wonderful. So we're aiming for 640 energy, and that'll help us buy our first colonist. Let's take a look-see, and it looks like we fully explored that region. Maybe we want to explore up northwest here, but this does not look like the best land I've ever seen. Suppose that we can make do. It is forcing us to do certain things in order to grow, but I am up to the challenge. All right, sweet. What did this give us?
4 billion-year-old world's worth of resources shared among a handful of people. We're gonna make a fortune here.
All right, sweet. We picked up chemistry, and we got 19 science out of that research pod. Oopsie, clicked out of the game. So we got the vivarium going, and this is good. Our growth is not half bad. And we can pick up the recycler now, which is going to really help our production out in this city of ours. So now it's time to pick up pioneering, because I really want to get the trade depot. Just as soon as I'm done with my recycler, and I'm off onto bigger and better things. Who has landed here? Again, that's not too close. The Slavic feds. All right.
Sputnik, Slavianska Federacja pozdrawiaje tybia.
Now, who does that leave? We've got Hutama, me, Reggie, Jamabare. I don't think Kavitha's landed yet, so it seems like Kavitha. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Kavitha might be the last person to make Planetfall. She should be making Planetfall up here somewhere, I suppose. I don't have a close neighbor yet. It's very rare that you have no close neighbor this late. Alright, so we're going to pick up... Let me read this. A relic. Okay. So actually, it looks like we're going to cut it off there. We will... I'm going to quickly make this decision. I'm not reading it. So we're going to cut it off there for the episode, and check in next time, and we will continue our journey with the Pan-Asian Cooperative on this new desert world. And we'll hopefully... we'll be able to transform this desert, horrible place into a wonderful supremacy empire. Take care.